when you talked about ordinariness, when you talked about
ordinariness, oh yeah,
some time before, I remembered something. Like the biggest transformation, let's say, happened after meeting you was like many years I was not working properly and I was just chasing spiritual growth, not really living it, but enjoying that intellectual journey.
Understand. I think we had a talk also in Goa. No?
Yes. And after meeting you, I came down from the sky and started working. And
how nice.
And then all the things I learned and gathered and accumulated really became very simple. And maybe you can say I started really living it before that. And it's very nice to be ordinary and simple and, yes. And enjoying the physical and taking care of the physical. And maybe I think energy came down from head to
heart. Or maybe somewhere, yeah.
Yes.
Wonderful. Yeah. I mean, I want to say here, it's very nice. I really appreciate what happened to you or happening, because I kind of could sense when we met first time that like something, there is something genuine about you or authentic, you know, like this. So because your desire was genuine to be truthful or to know the truth and to live the truth, but your direction was wrong. And when pointed, you corrected your direction. But there are many times, many beings whose desire is not there to know the truth. It is mostly to know it intellectually. And that's why even if it is pointed that go in this direction, they will continue going in this direction only, you know. So that is why my birds in this case worked, because you actually wanted to know the truth. It's just that you did not know what is the right direction, you know. So it is like we have worked together well, like, you know, like it has been a successful meeting like this in this case. Very happy. Because to appreciate ordinariness really takes a lot of courage. Like lot means all of the courage of the world you need when you have been living in that intellectual world, you know. Like you really has to be very genuinely interested in truth. Otherwise, you cannot really let go of that greatness of the mind where you feel like, wow, I know consciousness and I know many things like this. It's like a big balloon in which we live like this. And now you are coming back to very small being, body only, very basic capacity of seeing and, you know, but all authentic now. All authentic. And you have stopped believing in having things which you don't have, you know, like this. Very nice. Very nice. It is only going to, because what is happening now here is in you, you have decided to come to the reality of life. And from here, you can start sensing that reality kind of picks up here. Like you sense that, like an unfolding of a flower of love and light happens here, from here. From inside your heart, it happens like. And there is just nothing kind of judged inside you that whether flowing like this is right or wrong. It is all coming from the true light and cannot harm others. And you are not trying to be either specifically spiritual or human about it, you know. It's like a very beautiful mix of everything like this, you know. Yes. But just be alert that we have sort of an impulsive energy flow inside us, which is connected to the person only. And when this energy becomes free from the personal hold and limitation, it still tries to be impulsive about things like, you know, what we call like spiritual, alhad or something like this, you know, like, yeah, I'm so good, life is one, everybody is one, like this. This is one phase of the being. Just stay alert from it. It's not going to help you much. Be more sober and, or like, you know, simple. It is okay to dance and enjoy your life in the way you want, but it's definitely not okay to see it like some final truth or something like this, you know. Just stay alert about it. This thing doesn't help anybody except you. It will help you. It will clean things, but it has nothing to do with anybody else. So keep it private to you. You know what I mean? Like, it is like this, that I have myself learned bike and car, no? And I have also taught some people bike and car in different times. And what I found is the key here, how to balance, let's say bike in this case, balance the bike in the slow speed, not in the fast speed. Fast speed itself is like a support for balancing, but now you don't really know whether you are ready, whether you know the driving or not, you know, because suddenly something comes, you just crash like this. So this is the meaning of like this being ordinary is like you are moving at the slow speed and able to balance. Like when the high speed of energy comes from inside, anybody can balance because there is no time to balance anyway. It throws you out, it takes you over like this. So in this ordinariness, you know, I think you can correlate, no? Like work and everything. You get to see what is God, what is truth. And it is really, beloved, a holistic flowering or awakening that we are talking about. In our group, we talk, no, like the holistic approach. Everything together. You know? Because what is false inside you is not really a thing. It is an idea. Inside you, there is nothing false. There are things which are true and temporary, and there is something which is true and not temporary, constant. But everything is true inside you, everything. But if you believe they are your thoughts, it is false. But it is not a thing, it's just an idea, you know, like this. If you believe it is your body, it is again an idea, not a thing. Body is a thing, thoughts are a thing, feelings are things, like this. You know? Just a wrong way of looking at it. Correct can be corrected. But when we believe too much in the reality of what we think it is, then we try to rely on transformation, changes, and so on. Right. Very nice. It's nice. Yeah.
Thank you so much for holding this up.
Thank you. What is your name?
Deepti.
Deepti. Okay.
Noticing that as you're speaking, there's a lot of relief, especially when you said that the expression can also be light within us. And I'm very used to noticing the movements of the mind, you know, very used to noticing and observing that. And then you get into this, I get into this sense of helplessness that if I'm noticing it and if it is not going the way it should go, then what in me is not stopping it? What in me is not intervening in it? And that brings me more confusion, more despair. So as you said that, and maybe I sometimes ask myself, so who is it that wants to bring it to alignment? You know, and I don't get an answer at that time. So yeah, I'm noticing all of these things happening right now and coming to serve because I'm listening
yes.
to you.
Yes, very good what you said. Because the most typical part of awakening is not discovering yourself beyond person. It is what happens after that. Now, what to do about this person? And that's you, basically, mostly. Occasionally, you find yourself beyond this person, and most of the time, you find yourself as a person. What to do about it? This has been the, you know, work that we do together here also. A lot of work we do here. Like, what to do about it then? Because it is going to be again and again, you know, a sense of fear and sense of instability and this and that like this. That's what I call integration process, by the way. We have kind of different kind of integration modules we are developing slowly and practicing also, and they are effective also. Like what I call baby steps and what I call like, what do you call, bigger baby steps? Or
advanced baby steps.
Giant baby steps?
Advanced baby steps.
Advanced baby steps. But Gina, they are actually still advanced baby steps, what we have been doing here. No? What we do in the final program is the real integration. Like it is the real integration of consciousness. Right now it is the integration of the different components done by whoever you are or whoever you feel you are in this state right now. So what I'm trying to say here, Deepti, is that it is not something new happening to you only. It happens to everybody actually like this. But what is very important here is two points. One is understanding in some way that what is possibly happening to me. You cannot fully understand what's happening to you right now. But you kind of, if observe more and try to fix things less, can kind of find that ground which is common, and from there you are able to see the experience of stability and the joy when you are beyond the person state into your more deeper space, and also when you fall back into it, and also when you have a demand that I don't want to be in this personal space. Like, all of it can be seen from this deeper space. So try to understand more and bring everything in the same light. Rather than choosing, try to see more. You know, that's what I mean. Like, don't be in a hurry to fix things. Let this baby inside you keep crying that there are so many things unfixed and I'm still struggling and trying, still living as a person and what is happening to me and so on. You just see more clearly like this, without moving like this. It will all fix by itself.